Remorseless. 28 out of 32. I have 4 more Remorseless towers left. And personally, out of all that I'm doing, I think the hardest one would probably be Corrupted Nightmares. So I say we tackle the hardest tower that I have, the hardest rem I have left, and take down Corrupted Nightmares. So throughout this, I'm not going to do this item list. I'm going to use 3 healing items, except these are more of passive healing items more than anything. So when I come to a complete standstill, I'll be using this. These 2 will heal me over time when I place this down, and this one will double my regen health overall. But yeah, Corrupted Nightmares. God, am I not? I'm not excited. I'm not excited. This is just gonna be straight up hell. Like, no, I'm not gonna have an enjoyable time with this freaking tower, dude. I just gotta say, dude, I don't like this tower too much. I think it's cool, to be honest. I don't know, it's just cool. It has wonderful music. The music soundtrack for this tower is just outstanding. But the gameplay, everything else is just... It's a bit more on the, side. I mean, it's just, I mentioned it's a Kilbrick Hell Tower, so what do you expect? I'm not a fan of Kilbrick Hell Towers, so I'm not gonna like it too much. It's like one Kilbrick Hell Tower I can kind of enjoy. It's not even a tower, it's a steeple overgrowth. You know, I should probably be editing my GOE video, but like, nah, I'm guaranteeing you, if I can beat this rem, it's coming out before my GOE experience stuff, honestly. Maybe, it depends on how I feel. I mean, GOE won't be a hard sub-rem to edit, considering, like, it's a short sub-rem. I bursted through that sub-rem in like 2 hours. I didn't think that sub-rem was gonna be that short. I mean, it's a good sub-rem, such a good sub-rem. It's just so, it kind of sucks that it was like a short experience. But honestly, I think that's part of the reason why it's good. It's because it's short and whatnot. To be fair, it was meant to be more beginner friendly than anything, with the hardest thing there being like low intense. So, can't blame them. I cannot wait for when the boss fight comes out, for when we get to fight Ishul in the palace. I can't wait for the palace. But it probably won't come out for another couple months. Unless they're actually, like, still working on GOE as of now, which I have no idea. But if they are, dude, that's gonna be cool. I think they should do that so they can get GOE off their plate, off the table, and just then fully focus on the next zone. But it's whatever they do, honestly. I could care less what comes for Zone 6 or a palace. Though I would prefer the palace, because, you know, I'm a boss fight person. And also, that was not okay. But like I was saying, yeah, I'm really hyped for it. I really am curious what the bosses are gonna be like. I feel like, because I think Soda Slayer is gonna be like the boss you do before taking on the palace. I don't know. Soda Slayer is probably gonna be like the Christmas 2018 boss fight. Because, dude, the way it's built and structured is so similar. I'm not going to be surprised if it has, like, the exact same attacks. They're probably going to spice that boss up a bit. Guaranteed there's going to be new attacks. But I feel like there are going to be some attacks from the Sprite Cranberry boss from 2018. Which, honestly, that was a fun boss, from my recollection. Like, really freaking fun. I enjoyed it. I mean, probably won't enjoy it as much if I played it now. Considering the fact that nobody uses the past events and it would be hard to actually find people to fight the boss with and whatnot. But while for that time, it was fun. The Kilbrick Hell segment, yeah. Either I like get completely destroyed by that section or like scave out like with barely any health loss. It's so odd. Love this song, but I don't like these floors. Love the song, hate the floor. That's this tower, honestly, in a nutshell. Love the song, hate the tower, man. I mean, you gotta admit, the songs are... They're good choices. I think the songs, like, flow really well. Being honest and whatnot. And honestly, for Ring 4 standards, I would say this would be, like, a honest 2... God, honest to God, why was I gonna go honest to God? How insane is honest to God? Why do I like randomly get vocab that I would never use, like out of nowhere? But I would seriously say that this would be like a very cool tower and looks like enjoyable to do. I would say looks because I was not at skill level to do this tower. It's funny because this tower was just, I remember when this tower got moved up to insane. That was funny. She got moved up to insane. It's like, oh, new SC. Why not? It's definitely not SC though. It's a low rem. I was about to say low rem. It's not low rem either. It's definitely high rem. Definitely high rem. Well, here we are. Let's not do something dumb. The funny floor. Oh god. From here on out, these floors are gonna get nasty. Woo! Also have like really good music. Yeah, that's cool. That is such a Man discovered freaking rotation tool and was like, I'm going to use this in the worst way possible. The floors you really watch out for is 369. Because those are all the floors with the outside sections and whatnot. 9 definitely is going to be the deadliest. And descent to 3. You know what sucks about these wobbling platforms? Fact, there's like no resetters, so like once doing them the first time, it's not that bad, but on the second round, it's the worst. Why are you gonna do this to me? Don't rush. There we go, did that conveyor jump. Now we just got 9 outside. Actually kind of nervous. Timing is key with this, but I overall need to rush. I just need to know this one I can rely on. It's gonna be the second one. This thin stud part, it's gonna be the one that's gonna suck. Because I gotta actually pause to analyze this jump because I can't flat out rush it because it's to another thin stud, but I can't take too long. See, look how bulky this stack is alone. Like, it heals you quick. I should have probably done the one stacks first, you know, to be fair. Oh my god. And we got a shot. We have a genuine shot. But let's not call him. Ken could still very well be our demise. The balls. Surprisingly, the ball jumps in Corrupted Nightmares are easier than one. Actually, I spoke too soon. They're easier than the ones in Shattered Dreams. I always think this is a conveyor, man. Gotta play calm. But I'm generally nervous. This is probably the most nervous I've been on the Remorseless. This rem has caused me more pain than any other rem in the game. It truly has. Ah, that's been a really good senior way. There's one hard jump left still. I mean, a couple hard jumps. And those are those thin studs, man. Those thin studs at the end are not something to get cocky. You do not get cocky at the end of this tower. You just don't. And that's why you don't get cocky. What? I just got a lot of factors now into this. Yep. Nope. Yeah. Go kill your this stupid freaking
man. This tower that you freaking.
Of course, why wouldn't I eventually fail that? My god, bro.
My god, so cool. Let's make 6 outside literally the worst. Guys, let me put in the mega Kilbrick spam segment to where you gotta rush each and every jump. And then let me put the funny long freaking jump that, you know, you got a chance. It's a small chance that you'll... And let's put thin studs, and let's make it so annoying to actually line yourself up in first person. Because that is good gameplay, right? Are you ready for the corrupted nightmares? Can you handle the stress of this funny little tower? Are you ready for the pain that this tower is gonna bring you? Are you ready for it? You think handle it? Cause I surely can't. Can't? Oh my god, why?
Need to spin around my way. Done. Oh my lord. I hate that. Three rems. Dude, that's the most stressed I've been on a Remorseless tower. Oh my god, I hate that tower. I hate it with burning passion. I'm glad I got it over with. I did good making this my first rem of the four. Oh my god. That's just pain and agony. Oh, Seer's on 7 and whatnot. Oh my god. Okay. Yeah, now that we did that rem, we're gonna cut to that progress checker place to see what rem we're doing next. With corrupted nightmares being complete, I mean, Ring 4 is completely cleared on the non-SC stuff. All that remains is the SC of Ring 4. Ain't that beautiful? Seeing defeated. Ah, ha, ha. Oh, so good. Well, I guess we got one more rem in World 1. I could go ahead and take on Pastel Pillars, but I'm not going to. For this reason, there's one more tower that's going to also probably be just as annoying as Corrupted Nightmare, considering they were both made in around the 2018-2019 era. I think we all know what I'm talking about here. Tower of Zest Plus. But until then, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.